वेलकम एवरीवन टू माय चैनल एडुटेक। आई एम अब्दुल सलाम, असिस्टेंट टीचर। आई एम आल्सो एमआई एक्सपर्ट 2020-2021 फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू नॉमिनेट योर सेल्फ एज एन एमआई एक्सपर्ट फॉर 2021 टू 2022। जस्ट ओपन ए ब्राउजर एंड सर्च माइक्रोसॉफ्ट इवेंट कोर, देन यू विल फाइंड द वेब एड्रेस msedu.eventcore.com। जस्ट क्लिक द सेकेंड ऑन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एडुकेटर कम्युनिटीज FY22 फॉर्म इवेंट कोर। प्लीज क्लिक दिस ऑप्शन। ओके, देन यू विल एंटर द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एडुकेशन प्रोग्राम्स। यू कैन अप्लाई एज एन एमआई एक्सपर्ट एंड शोकेज स्कूल्स। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू एज एन एमआई एक्सपर्ट हाउ कैन यू अप्लाई फॉर दिस प्रोग्राम। देयर आर ऑप्शन रजिस्टर नाउ और साइन इन। यू कैन क्लिक दिस ऑप्शन, जस्ट रजिस्टर और साइन इन। ओके, जस्ट क्लिक दिस वन। ओके, देन यू विल फाइंड द फोर ऑप्शन, फेसबुक, माइक्रोसॉफ्ट अकाउंट, वर्क फॉर स्कूल अकाउंट एंड माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एम्प्लॉय। आई वॉन्ट टू शो यू माइक्रोसॉफ्ट अकाउंट एज ए पर्सनल अकाउंट। जस्ट क्लिक दिस आइकॉन। Okay, then enter your email address and sign in with your password. Okay, then you will find a self nomination hub. If you are new, just create an account and sign in. Write here your personal details. I want to show you by editing my personal information. Okay. Please check your contact information, your name, your personal email address, your school organization email address, to which email address would you like program communication sent. I will use my personal email address. There are also your home address, shipping address. You can include your original shipping address here, city, town and zip code. As the same school information, just include your school name, your school address, school zip code, your school website, organization website, school country and postal code. Current role at school: I am directly responsible for teaching K-12 students, so I just pick this one. Then I would like to hear from Microsoft and its family and companies. Just click the this two option and then save and submit. All right, then you will find the self nomination hub. If you are new, just click add new self nomination. If you want to edit, just click edit nomination. When you click the edit nomination, then you will find two option, contact information and self nomination. Just click self nomination, then you will check your self nomination details. I want to edit my procedure to show you clearly. Okay, just follow the instruction. Please subscribe my channel. Okay, at first, is your school a showcase school, incubator school, or neither? So I will pick this one, neither, and I have to include my school name here. If you are a showcase school, just search your school name here. If you have an incubator school, just search your school name. If you are new, so just click the neither and add your school here. What age range do you teach? Select all that apply. I am totally connected with the grade 9 to 11, 12 to 14, 15 to 18 years old students. What subject do you teach? I teach us in literature, Bengali literature, mathematics, science and physical education. If you are a teacher, if you teach us one subject, just pick the one subject. Okay. Do your student learner have access to internet at school? Yes, I have access in my school. If you have no, so you pick the no. do your students learner have access to internet at home? Yes, some of them do. Some of my students have internet connection in their home. What technology do your students learner primarily use for learning? Mobile phone, laptops, shared device, etc. Share the URL to your social handles. I have included my Twitter handle, Facebook handle, LinkedIn, TikToks, YouTube channels. I have also included my others Skype handle, the personal communications. So how many followers do we have on Twitter? I have 146 followers on Twitter. What tools device do you use regularly? Google Apps, Chromebooks, Windows device, Microsoft 365, Teams, and Zoom. I usually use this app. What tools device does your school organization use? My school are using Google Apps, Chromebooks, Microsoft 365, Microsoft Teams, and Zoom. With what other edutech communities are you connected? Take all that apply. Edutech communities, I have connected Adobe Creative Educators. I have also connected with this Adobe Creative Educators, but I am not a creative educator. Bansi Educators, I am also connected with Bansi, but I am not a Bansi ambassador. Okay. Flipgrid Student Voice Ambassador, I am also Flipgrid Student Voice Ambassador. Kahoot Ambassador, I am not a Kahoot Ambassador, but I am a Kahoot Academy Verified Educators. Mars Ambassador, I am also working with Mars Ambassador programs. And Minecraft Global Mentor, I am also working with Minecraft. Nearpod Certified Educator, I am also working with Nearpod. And Worklet Ambassador, I am also working in Worklet. And others, I have also included here T4 Ambassador, District Ambassador of Teachers Portal of Bangladesh. I am also District Ambassador of Teachers Portal of Bangladesh. Have you taken any coursework or earned any badges and trophies on Microsoft Learn? Yes, I have earned about 6 badges and trophy from Microsoft Learn. So I will pick the yes. If you don't work with Microsoft Learn, just click no. Okay. And I have also included my Microsoft Learn profile link here. How many course learning path or training on the Microsoft Educator Center have you completed? I have completed about 200 course. So I will click 226 or more. Provide a link to a transcript from a Microsoft Educator community by following these steps. I just go to your Microsoft Educator centers, then download your transcript and upload it as on Drive or Google Drive. Just then copy the link and share here. But remember that when you share the link, it should be a editable option. Okay, so that someone can edit your link easily, your file easily. Phase two, how often do you use the following M365 tools? I use Microsoft Teams daily. How often do you Microsoft Form weekly use query? How often do you use OneNote monthly? OneNote or Staff Notebook Professional weekly? OneNote Class Notebook with Learners weekly? Webinar Knowledge weekly? How often do you use Flipgrid with Learners weekly? I also use Flipgrid. How often do you use Minecraft Education Editor with learners monthly? You can share. If you not use, just click never, rarely, etc. How often do you use the following STEM resource tools with learners? MacCode weekly, Hacking STEM monthly, Microsoft Imagine Academy weekly. You can click rarely, never, daily, etc. If just pick that, your right answer truly, just fill the form truly. Live presentation. How often do you use the following features of PowerPoint for teaching learning? Live presentation weekly, recording lessons weekly, PPT into video weekly, presenter course monthly, subtitles monthly, embedding form weekly, inking rarely. How often do you and you or your learners use the features of the Microsoft Edge browser? Immersive Reader daily, use query, read aloud daily, extension weekly, translation daily, ink on PDF weekly, generating QR codes weekly, collection daily, web capture daily. It's absolutely daily and weekly because I also involve with myself with my students and educators around the world every day. So I have to work with them. How many Flipgrid virtual field trips have you joined in the past 6 months? About 20 field trips I have already joined. How many Gridpal connection I have completed? About 18 plus. Just I have included 18. So the immersive reader and learning tools student can check all that apply. I think a student can do everything by using immersive reader. Just pick this one, collaborate with others through that set. Accessibility checker in tools like PowerPoint, Word, Excel, OneNote, Outlook, etc. should be used for. The third one will be perfect. Verifies your file against a set of rules that identify possible issue for people who have a variety of disabilities. Okay. In a hybrid classroom, Team is used for meeting environment with video, collaboration, person, bring a guest speaker, embedding other tools, etc. And another one, formative assessment during the lessons unit, when you create a quiz or a full Microsoft form, all facilities are included with Microsoft form, just pick all option here. Choice, ranking, text, rating and link card. Like that. When using OneNote, students can create their own practice math assessment with forms that will show them if they got the correct answer. Yes, true. What type of teams are available with Microsoft Teams in education? I think all facilities are included with Microsoft Teams. What is the correct order of the following for how to create breakout rooms in Teams? I have filled this form correctly. You can fill this form correctly. Just at first launch the Microsoft Teams desktop apps, select calendar, new meeting, show the channel to meet in order in or add the learners you want to attend, join the meeting, select breakout room for the meeting control, choose how many rooms you would like to create, choose automatically or manually, select create room. Absolutely right. Then phase 3, this is very important. Why are you an MI expert 2020-21? If you are new, just click no. If you are old, just click yes. Then fill this form. Describe how you contributed to the MI expert community to support other MI expert and the growth of your colleagues. Just included about an information about yourself, how you contributed yourself with your students, with your colleagues. Just included information about 500 to 2000 or 2000 liters. I will share you. Describe how you leverage Microsoft tools to increase accessibility for all learners in your classroom. How you leverage Microsoft tools accessibility for learners in your classroom. Just included an information about the same, the first one and second one at the same. Just include the 500 to 2000 meters. Tell us about a series of lessons, unit or project they do with your learners that incorporates Microsoft technology for improved learning outcomes. What 21st century learning design skills were included in the learning and explain in detail how those skills are developed. I think you will be able to guide the information. Just read out and write it in your own style. Don't copy this word. The fourth one, provide a link to an example of learning artifact from a project you learned or completed using Microsoft tools. Just share the link here. You can use your Sway link, YouTube links, and PowerPoint video link, etc. Describe what the artifact is, how it demonstrated the desired learning objectives, and how Microsoft tools are a critical part of the learning. Just included the information about your own way. Okay. Share two examples of how you have supported both your own learning and the learnings and growth of your colleagues. Describe the activities that you completed and led and how it resulted in better technique and learning. Just included the information and click the if accepted. Okay. When we have filled this form, just click save and submit. Then you will get a notification message in your mobile phone and your email, and you have to move from the phase 3, and I think you will be ready for the next programs, MI Expert 2021 to 2022. Now I am going to show you how to about the last 6 question, phase 3 6 question as a PowerPoint presentation. Just see this presentation. Okay, and to show you, okay, the phase 3 6 question, and to show you Microsoft Innovative Educator MI Expert nomination questions, the last 4 questions. Why are you an MI Expert in 2020-21? Yes, no. If you are yes, just describe how you contributed to the MI Expert community to support other MI Expert and the growth of your colleagues. 500 characters to 2000 characters. Okay, phase 3, question 1. The answer I have right here as my own style. You can edit this information. Absolutely, you have to edit this information and write it as your own way. Okay, don't copy as the same way. As an MI expert, I have contributed myself with others MI expert and with my colleagues. I have arranged different face-to-face and virtual training session for my colleagues like Microsoft Teams, Sway, OneNote, Microsoft Form, Flipgrid, Kahoot, Bansi, Wacklit, etc. I have also supported other MI expert to use the Microsoft tools in education. So I have arranged about 15 remote learning webinar with global MI expert by using Microsoft Teams. As an MI expert, I have also created different Skype group and Facebook groups to grow up my colleagues with global MI expert for hybrid learning, so that they will be able to enhance their skills for 21st century. Building a professional learning network of connecting with active educators that they use different inclusive Microsoft learning tools. By joining the MI expert program, build me a strong educators for my country and also the worldwide. As an MI expert, I want to use all Microsoft tools to make an inclusive classroom for hybrid learning. If I select as an MI expert, I will contribute myself not only for my students but also my colleagues and others global educators, also to share my skills to use the Microsoft tools in education. Describe how you leverage Microsoft tools to increase accessibility for all learners in your classroom. Phase 3, question number 2. The answer: at present, Microsoft tools are most popular tools for education, especially Microsoft Teams, PowerPoint, Live, Skype, OneNote, Sway, MathSolver, Kahoot, Flipgrid are using in the classroom for better learning. Microsoft Teams are covered with all facilities of hybrid classroom. I am using Microsoft Form to create different quiz, short question, long answer question to evaluate my students in the classroom. Microsoft PowerPoint presentation is mostly common tools that I use daily in my manual and online classes. I share the Sway link to my students to showcase or share a presentation also. If I want to make a virtual classroom, then I use Microsoft Teams for better learning. I am passionate about my teaching and learning, want to inspire students with creative thinking and work in a truly collaborative spirit to share their learning with the world. I am able to share their learning with colleagues and other educators through local training programs in their own school system. The first three, question 3. Tell us about a series of lessons, unit, or project you did with learners that incorporates Microsoft technology for improved learning outcomes. For 21st century learning design skills are included in the learner's learning and explain in detail how those skills are developed. Phase 3, question 3. I have included myself with Microsoft technology. I have also engaged my students with different schools around the world with collaborative projects to exchange culture like language, cloth, foods, festivals. I use Microsoft Form to create quiz, Microsoft Teams, and Skype to collaborate with other countries. Students who are 21st century learning design skills are involved. My students are really happy to use the Microsoft tools in the classroom. These tools help my students to consume content, create content, collaborate inclusively, and stay organized. Consuming content and creating content, learning tools, reading mode as an access center, creating content, PowerPoint designer, OneNote, Swift, Flipgrid, Kahoot, etc. The phase 3, question 4. Provide a link to an example of a learning artifact from a project your learners completed using Microsoft tools. Just share the URL. I have shared a URL of a short Sway. You can use a Sway or YouTube video link. Phase 3, question 5. Describe what the artifact is to which you shared a link, how to demonstrate the desired learning objectives, and how Microsoft tools are a critical part of the learning. Phase 3, question 5. I have write the answer in my own style. Microsoft tools are most important for better learning. We can use it in easy way to make an inclusive classroom. When I share my lessons by using Microsoft PowerPoint presentation, my students learned perfectly. I felt happy when my students respond smoothly in Microsoft form, in quizzes, assignments, surveys, and long questions. I make the result by using Microsoft Excel and share it with my students. OneNote, SharePoint, MathSolver, Sway are also an important for my students. Microsoft Teams are now most popular tools for students' hybrid learning. By using Microsoft Teams, I can connect with my students and share my lessons, assignment, homework, quiz easily. Microsoft Edge browser are also important for my students. To make a lesson fruitful, I use immersive readers, read aloud, grammar tools, web capture, and other tools. I think now I am able to fulfill the demand of learning of my students. The phase 3, question 6. Share two examples of how you have supported both your own learning and the learning and growth of your colleagues. Describe the activities that you completed and led and how it resulted in better teaching and learning. First question answer. I have a good relation with my colleagues in this global epidemic situation. Our school is still closed from 16 March 2020. I was searching a better learning way for my colleagues and also my personal improvement. I make a plan to use Microsoft Teams for better learning. At first, I created an Office 365 education account. Then I use it in Microsoft Teams. I find a lot of tools in it. I have created few teams for different activities like quizzes, forms, Kahoot quizzes, assignments, etc. Now I can make a virtual classroom with my students and colleagues to use Microsoft Teams, unlimited times for communication, and share our activities. I also share this idea with my colleagues. The another activities is Microsoft PowerPoint presentation live in Office 365 education version. I have created some specific presentation and I also share it and the techniques with my colleagues so that they are now able to use it easily with their students and others field. At present, my colleagues are really happy to learn this teaching idea to share with their students. So thank you everyone to stay with me. I hope it will be helpful for you to apply for an MI expert. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel and stay with me.